This is Uhuru Zem News. History, Benin Igala War of 1515 to 1516. What led to the war from Benin Igala perspectives? During the reign of Oba Ẹsigie around 1504, there was a prominent chief called Oliha. Chief Oliha had an addiction. It was the woman at the center of his world. Many understood why he loved and adored his wife to a dangerous level. She was easy on the eyes. Her name was Imaguero. She was very famous for her beauty, and Chief Oliha felt very lucky to own such a breathtaking female. Whenever he showed up at the palace, he would brag to anyone who cared to listen about the faithfulness of his precious Imaguero. According to Chief Oliha, this rare beauty was the kindest, most faithful woman in Benin. His fellow elites were more impressed than amused. Some secretly envied him and wished they had a woman that could compete with Oliha's jewel of inestimable value. As time went by, Oba Ẹsigie had some scores to settle with Chief Oliha. The king decided to hit his chief where it mattered most. Conniving with palace staff and some mischievous members of his cabinet, Oba Ẹsigie set out to investigate Imaguero's major weakness. In no time, he discovered that she was just as vain as the next pretty woman. She loved things. Imaguero particularly loved expensive coral beads. She couldn't get enough of them. Those close to her knew it was her worst distraction. Oba Ẹsigie didn't waste much time. He summoned one of his porters, an elderly lowlife commoner, a cripple for that matter, called Yuk, for the errand. The king gave him a few coral beads and agate, with strict orders to tempt Imaguero. The porter set about his task. The servant was able to seduce and win Imaguero, the perceived faithful wife of the proud Chief Oliha. She fell quickly, after accepting expensive, royal coral beads and agate. The handicapped servant ravished her beautiful body to maximum satisfaction. Having successfully carried out the mission, he returned to the king, who appreciated Yuke's effort. In the meantime, Oba Ẹsigie patiently waited for a dramatic moment to finish with the plot. One day, when all the chiefs were assembled and conversing, as usual, Chief Oliha began to boast about his wife again. Fascinated by Oliha's ignorance, the king summoned his disabled porter. In front of the entire assembly of chiefs, he instructed the porter to tell the tale of Imaguero's successful seduction for the sake of a few coral beads and agate stones. Everyone was shocked. Of course, they mocked Oliha for trusting a beautiful woman too much. Humiliated that Imaguero slept with a cripple, Chief Oliha returned home in pain, shame, and anger. When he entered his matrimonial home, his emotions got the better of him. In that mood, he presented to her a symbolic pot of death. The pot of sword and poison. Consequently, he slew the love of his life. Imaguero died a brutal death by strangulation. Embittered by the shame, Chief Oliha decided to get even with Oba Ẹsigie. His plan was to dethrone the king. He knew he wouldn't get support from the king's subjects, and so he instigated the Ada of Ada in Igala against the Oba, by turning both leaders against each other through disinformation. Chief Oliha informed the Ada that the Oba was preparing to wage war on Igala people. In the same vein, Oba Ẹsigie was told that the Ada was gearing up for an offensive on Edo Kingdom. The Ada war was fierce. The war ended in the defeat of the Ada people of Igala. The use of guns purchased from the Portuguese may have aided the crushing defeat inflicted on the Adas. It was during the reign of Ẹsigie that guns were introduced for the first time into the kingdom. It was to avoid a future incursion into Edo land that led to the establishment of garrison towns. From Igala perspective of Benin-Ida War. The tribe that occupy Ida is called Igala. That the Igala kingdom has never been defeated in any war in all of its history. This statement is not true, as there are three or so recorded wars in which the Igala army was roundly defeated and had to beat a hasty retreat in each case. These are as follows. The Benin Empire's conquest and occupation of Igala land in 1507 AD, when the Igala army was no match for the more numerous soldiers of the Benin army. The Igala-Benin War of 1515 to 1516 AD end. The first was the war led by a Benin prince, Aji Ada, against Ada Ogala Eri in 1507. In the year 1507, Oba Ozoluwa of Benin ordered his son, Aji Ada, to lead a segment of the Bini army against Ada Ogala Ariad Ida, which prompted a sudden journey of the incumbent into self-exile, first, to the southern part of the Bainway Basin, then later, to NRI in the present-day Anambra State. Robert Arthur Sargent, in his 1984 PhD thesis, titled, Politics and Economics in the Bainway Basin, reports that the Benin army had attacked, conquered and occupied the Igala land to establish a Bini, or Ajiata, dynasty. The second war in which the Igala troops were defeated was the Ajiata-Oba Ẹsigie face-off, a war of two brothers having the same father, which early historians erroneously referred to as the Gala-Benin War of 1515-1516. 8 years after Ajiata had conquered and seized the Ada's throne and land, he mobilized the kingdom's army to fight and remove his brother, Oba Ẹsigie, who was installed in 1509, and take over the throne, but the Igala army was roundly defeated. Another Igala oral history has it that Princess Inikpi was the only beloved daughter of Iyegbu Oma Idoko, the then Ada of Igala Kingdom. The Igala people call her Inikpi Omafido Baba, meaning Inikpi, the father's beloved. A brooding war between Benin and the Igala people caused the land to become unsafe, farmlands being taken over by Benins and the streams poisoned. The Igalas feared imminent death from starvation and lack of water. When the Ada consulted the oracle, it proclaimed that to ensure safety of the kingdom and victory in the war, the king had to bury his most beloved child alive, the only daughter of the king, Princess Inikpi. Surely, the king was distraught and heartbroken. For days, he didn't eat or drink, and he wished for an alternative solution. The princess noticed how downcast her father was and asked to know the reason behind his sadness. Instead of opening up, he held off telling her the reason for 7 days, but on the eighth, he relented and told her the words of the oracle. The princess, who loved her father and her people as much as they loved her, could not bear the thought of holding off on the solution that would save Igala land. Therefore, she agreed to be sacrificed and set off voluntarily to the bank of River Niger at Ida, some say Market Square, where she was buried along with 9 slaves who would help her in the journey to the afterlife. Legend has it that when the Benins approached Igala Kingdom, what they saw was a town in flames, and so they turned back with the assumption that the town Ida was already under attack. However, it was the influence of the sacrifice. For this, the Igala people are forever deeply grateful to Princess Inikpi for her sacrifice and act of heroism. A statue of the princess stands at EGA in Ida, which is considered the Igala traditional headquarters, and many Igala people bear the name Inikpi to honor her. Several plays have also been produced to celebrate her story. Regarding Imaguero, I know what you are thinking. Why is history kind to Imaguero if she was an unfaithful wife? Why was a college named after her? Well, her end may as well be a reminder to us not to trust anyone totally. A reminder that there's always a price tag. A reminder of the need to stay humble and not brag about what you have just to torture others emotionally. A reminder that there are consequences for unfaithfulness. Please, if there is any history you want us to talk about, write on the comment. Thanks for watching.